You've heard rumors that skinny jeans are out and you don't have as much time as you'd like. You're looking for a few key pieces to keep you looking up to date, elegant and relevant, and decidedly not mutton dressed as lamb. And knowing where to start to find and evolve your personal style over 40 is the subject of today's video. I'm Aleksandra Olenska, and I've worked as a creative director and stylist for luxury brands, including Chanel, Celine and Vanessa Bruno, as well as magazines, including Vogue and Harper's Bazaar. And I've been featured in international press, including Forbes, Elle, The Sunday Times, and The Independent. I now help directors and leaders in midlife and beyond to rebalance that work, 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 busy, busy, busy lifestyle you've become accustomed to, because you know life's too short to stay in that career-driven comfort zone. I help you to redesign and restyle your life, especially at midlife with life-changing transitions, such as the breakup of relationship, divorce, menopause, or turning 40 and beyond. From your home and your wardrobe to your mind and social life, I help you with your stylish next chapter to step into your best life, because I know you're ready to rock life again. Age can give you the confidence to wear other things, to not give a damn what other people think. But changes in body shape can also leave us feeling a little lost and not like ourselves. Fashion today is about expressing yourself through your style, and one of the best places to start is to get back to yourself. You know you don't want to feel like mutton dressed as lamb, and the question to really ask yourself, therefore, is how do you want to feel? And then what can I do, and what can I surround myself with right now to help me feel like this? What can you wear, and what can you tweak in your home? Maybe you want to feel calm and sexy, for instance. How does that feel to you? Explore it. What color is calm? What does it sound like? What does it smell like? And what about sexy? How does that feel? How does that express itself to you? What can you do to get into that calm and sexy mood, right? Light some candles and allow yourselves to dream of champagne cocktails and palm trees in the sunshine, or whatever works for you to get you into your version of how you want to feel. It's a great starting place. I often start by looking through my books and revisiting some of my favourite places if possible. We all know that getting ourselves outside and out of our daily routine is one of the most beneficial things that we can do to feel revived and refreshed, to get back to ourselves. What can you read? What can you watch? Feed your soul with that will help you to express or feel sexy and calm. Use a multi-sensorial approach to really immerse yourself, your whole self, from the inside out into how you want to feel. We're so inundated with information today that we passively consume, scrolling Instagram and with 24-hour news that seems to repeat and repeat on a loop. That can be great, but it's much more powerful to actively and intentionally decide how you want to feel and what you're consuming and surrounding yourself with in order to help you get there. To me, calm is a soft, pale peachy colour that leaves me feeling calm and gentle and reminds me of powdery sunsets over the desert. I love to wear shades of off-white that help me to feel warm and at peace. A yellow gold colour radiates warmth, as do pearls. They hint at sunshine and glowiness. And if you know me, you know that I feel more energised and happy and free in the sun. Calm to me sounds like soft rain on a summer's day and the sound of ocean waves, not quite rhythmically stroking the shore. A picture of turquoise waves on the coral shore adorns my bathroom. I look at it while I'm brushing my teeth and it helps me to dream. It reminds me of holidays and different versions of life that we lead. It makes me smile and it helps me with the inner calm. Calm to me smells like freshly washed linen and the lilies that grew in the garden of my childhood. Having lilies in my home, I find myself breathing more deeply as I inhale that strong and delicious smell. A perfume from Santa Maria Novella likewise reminds me of clean sheets and gives me a spritz of fresh, joyful calm throughout the day. As for sexy, well, I think I'll keep that one to myself right now. Let me know in the comments below how you'd like to feel as the most gorgeous and stylish version of yourself, whatever your age. Of course, if you want to feel slim and fabulous, there are also more practical tips for getting there. I'll pop the link to my free style reset guide down below and see my video on the menopausal midriff to help you along. And do subscribe to my channel if you'd like more style inspiration to help you feel fabulous, confident, and beautiful at midlife and beyond. So now that you've worked out how you want to feel and how to get there, don't forget to dress for your current life and not an old version for yourself that's no longer serving you. When you're comfortable, you're confident. But that doesn't mean you can't be stylish and comfortable or explore new sides to yourself that may have been hidden for a while. What with the busyness of children or family or social engagements, relationships and commitments to others. Limit any old baggy, saggy, comfy clothes or mountains of athleisure that may have increased during the pandemic and that can leave you feeling disconnected from yourself and not feeling like that juicy version of yourself that you know is in there. In this case, that calm and sexy version of yourself. Reflect on what else in your life you need to consider in your outfits, such as perimenopause, health concerns, transport, that will affect the way that you feel in your clothes and the way that you ultimately hold yourself in them. Then what you need, of course, is a more streamlined wardrobe and a more conscious approach to clothes. Check out my simple style system and declutter your wardrobe videos. I'll pop them in the links below to get you started on the next step to feeling like a more gorgeous version of yourself. Et voilà! Merci and thank you for watching. À la prochaine. Bye bye.